Before the start of Russian aggression, national identity case was considered in a very narrow way, only as political or linguistic issue, anyway, not as an important security case. Since 2014 until now, issues such as Ukrainian language, policy of national memory, national identity, have become main points of creating a new model of human security in Ukraine. In my opinion, it's important to realize that Russian war against Ukraine had been prepared by Russia during a long time. It was a special part of all preliminary Putin's politics on Ukraine. And a key point of this politics was destroying Ukrainian national and identity, especially on these territories, and strongly promoting topics and visions of Russia world to people in these territories. An approach was simple. There is no Ukrainian language on these territories. It means there is no Ukrainian identity. It means people who live on these territories are not Ukrainians but Russians, and it means they need to be protected by Russia troops. And next steps must be or annexation or self-proclaimed so-called People's Republic. And as we know, unfortunately, it happened. But how did it happen? But why did it happen? During a long time, Ukrainian officials didn't concentrate on any national identity issues, such as Ukrainian language as a key marker of Ukrainian national identity, protection and development of Ukrainian language in generally, respect to real Ukrainian history, and of course respect to national memory. Now, especially on these territories that are now occupied by Russia troops. Now all these issues are on agenda, and all issues of national identity are definitely crucial. In my opinion, last 3 or 4 years, both government and parliament have implemented three key things. First, and approval of decommunization legislation by Ukrainian parliament. Second, strengthening positions of Ukrainian language on TV, radio, and in schools, of course. And third, protecting of Ukrainian information space, cinema industries, book markets, and so on. In protecting book markets and so on, and protecting from different kinds of Russian propaganda. And these issues tell us about start of about the beginning of very crucial and very important, difficult, and long-term process of mental decolonization of Ukraine. It's crucial to my country because it has never ever been before, since 17th century, when Ukraine was occupied by Russia. My task, in my opinion, my task as a member of the government, as well as the task of my colleagues, is to defend human space of Ukraine, which for which a long time was repeatedly attacked from Russian propaganda, but in different forms and different time. But it's tough work because Russia propaganda machine has huge possibilities to continue information and cyber, by the way, aggression against Ukraine. So a key point in this case for us is further cooperation with our European and transatlantic partners. And recent incidents in the UK and other countries show us one more time that Russian activities are unlimited. And it requires responsibly and active countermeasures. So I think, I am confident that the Ukrainian government will continue to be a reliable partner for our Western friends in case of democracy, rule of law, and support of democratic values as the most important values to every free human and to whole free worlds.